My work is designed to give politicians and policymakers the information they need to make better decisions for better public health. I'm Gregg Gonsalves. I'm an assistant professor of epidemiology at the Yale School of Public Health. My research is at the interface of human rights and public health research and practice. It's devoted to addressing the inequities in health services for poor and marginalized populations. I dropped out of college in the 80s at the height of the AIDS epidemic and ended up joining an activist group called ACT UP. In my 40s, I decided I wanted a new set of tools to do the work and decided to come back to school, getting a degree in biology and then a PhD in public health with a mind towards taking quantitative tools to improve the responses to public health and AIDS service provision all across the world. I use a variety of quantitative techniques to address deficiencies in the provision of care, largely for HIV. One of the projects I'm working on now is using a set of algorithms or mathematical tools that were originally designed to figure out how to go to the hottest slot machine in a casino, but we're using that same kind of thinking and decision-making algorithms to figure out where to test for HIV infection to find the greatest number of HIV-positive people who are still undiagnosed and don't know their status. I consider my work a hybrid, a mix of different kinds of disciplines and approaches. One is that of social justice and human rights activism, and the other is of public health research, quantitative analysis, and science. And I think they're both necessary in order to sort of combat key public health crises. In 2012, Amy Kupczynski, Ali Miller, and myself got together to form the Global Health Justice Partnership, which was a collaboration between Yale's public health school and law school. And the idea was to address the inequities in health around the world. You need a combination of legal reform, social mobilization, and advocacy. We found by combining these three approaches to social and health injustice, we can make improvements with our partners around the world. We've had a variety of projects with different non-governmental organizations. We've worked in partnership with groups to think through the issues that confront them, whether it's the cholera outbreak in Haiti, whether it's silicosis and tuberculosis among gold miners in southern Africa, whether it's the cost of hepatitis C drugs around the world. We're trying to sort of put together partners between academia, non-governmental organization, and others who care about these issues to sort of push things forward. We have a paper which looks at the Scott County HIV outbreak. And through a mathematical model, we can recreate the dynamics of what happened there over the years from 2011 to 2015. We use data to sort of offer counterfactuals or what-if statements based in data and based in rigorous analysis to sort of give policymakers a window onto what would have happened if they had done the right thing. This quest is personal. In 1996, I found out I was HIV positive. And the fight for social justice and for health equity has deep roots in my own personal history, but also I belong to a worldwide community now of people fighting for the rights of people with tuberculosis, with hepatitis, with HIV. And it's not a career, it's a passion, it's my life's work.